This vehicle modification discussion is meant for entertainment and discussion purposes only. Never modify your vehicle yourself. Always have certified experts perform vehicle maintenance or modifications. For those who own a first-generation Mitsubishi Outlander PHEV, and like me, would like to prioritize the EV aspect of the vehicle, well, there's a frustration that comes with many PHEVs. And that is, they often don't care if you want to use gas or not. The Outlander, like many other vehicles in this category, doesn't really take into account what you want. Sure, there's a large EV button in your center console, but it's about as effective as requesting a window seat when boarding a fully booked plane. You can ask, but it really won't change anything. If you push the gas pedal a little too hard, or if the temperature gets a little too chilly outside, here comes that gasoline engine, like it or not. Even if you're not asking the vehicle for heat, it'll burn some gas just to warm it up in case you want it later. Now, I know there are technical reasons why the engine might turn on for the good of the vehicle, so let's all acknowledge right here and now what I'm going to talk about from here on out is A, a bad idea, B, something you should never do to your car, and C, something that, if you have a large farm or ranch and you're not going to drive on public roads, is something you could do to your car, in order to transform it into a fully electric vehicle. In a nutshell, and I learned this from user K. Patrov on the MyOutlanderPHEV.com forums, you can simply remove this relay from under the hood and the vehicle will never turn on the gasoline engine. Because it can't. It's missing an essential part of its circuit. But it'll still start and drive using only the battery and the vehicle's two electric motors, one for each axle. Having said that, your vehicle will not be happy. Your dash will light up like a Christmas tree with all sorts of lights. Check engine, tire monitor warning, EV service warning, engine overheating warning, closed fuel lid warning, and perhaps one or two other lights will illuminate on your dash. Basically, the car can't see the combustion engine anymore, so it just throws up all its red flags. You also won't get an estimated travel distance range. Your speedometer and charge meter work, as do your fuel and battery charge gauges. You still get heated seats, a heated steering wheel, but only the bottom half because thanks Mitsubishi, and if your vehicle is equipped with an electric heater, that'll work too. Radio works fine, as does all of your essential driving lights, signals, brakes, mirrors, defrosters, etc. So really, in this state, the vehicle complains, but it operates as an electric motor vehicle would, albeit an underpowered one. I'm going to use rough figures here, but the first generation Outlander PHEV has around 205 horsepower. This is derived from a 117 horsepower gasoline engine and dual 80 horsepower electric motors, one for each axle. But what happens in this situation is we've removed the 170 horsepower engine, so we're left with roughly a 2-ton 80 horsepower vehicle. Is it underpowered? Yeah. Dangerously so? I personally don't think so. I admit there's room for debate here. For one, there are far slower vehicles on the road than this. Trucks, older vehicles, older drivers, and non-standard vehicles all operate slower than this would. Secondly, if you put the pedal down in the Outlander in this modified state, you can absolutely accelerate to that 80 or 90 km per hour speed limit on the freeway on-ramp. Don't ask me how I know, because again, I would never do this to my own vehicle, but it has been tested by others. Once you get to highway speeds, however, you really start to notice the impact on acceleration. You can absolutely still accelerate to higher speeds, but it takes longer, and it'll really hit your battery consumption hard. Which brings us to the major consideration that comes with this modification. You've got to be diligent. The only discernible way to know how much range you have left is with the EV charge indicator. Though, come to think of it, the same could be said about a fuel gauge in a gas-powered vehicle. Regardless of type, you always have to know what your stored energy availability is. It's just that, in this scenario, you get, at most, 50 kilometers of range from full, and that's if you're really babying it, so you gotta be paying attention. Still, if you had a short commute, didn't travel on major roads with extended periods of high speed limits, and wanted to make sure you never had to use gas unnecessarily, this could work for you. You would also have to take on the responsibility to confirm that this type of vehicle modification doesn't break any local laws. But even then, every time you need to use your gas engine, you'd need to turn off the car, get out, pop the hood, put the relay back in, and restart the car. But what if there's a better way? Well, that's where this modification comes in. A simple explanation is, put in a switch which allows you to connect or disconnect this circuit from within the comfort of your vehicle. You simply obtain the proper size spade connectors, two sets each of 9.5mm and 6.5mm, some 8-gauge wiring, I like to be on the safe side, and some type of switch. A wireless remote RF switch could work, or you could try to run a physical wire right into the cabin through your firewall, but that is tricky on this vehicle. Really though, you're just moving the relay socket out a bit and putting a switch in. This is the diagram which I saw used and worked for the test case. Three of the four connectors are directly connected to the socket via the wire, with this last connector attached to a wireless RF switch, a physical switch, or both for redundancy. Then you can remotely remove and plug in this relay whenever you want to from inside your vehicle. But remember, you must make the switch while the vehicle is turned off. If you started off in modified EV mode, you cannot re-engage the gas engine while you're driving. It just won't work. You need to pull over, turn off the car, then flip the switch, and then get back on the road with normal factory mode. The errors on your dash will clear themselves up over the following days. I don't actually know what would happen if you disconnected the relay while you were driving with the gas engine on. I suspect it would cut the engine, but I wouldn't want to do this when the vehicle was in motion. For this reason, I would recommend a protected switch, one that can't accidentally be flipped off when the engine is running. In modified EV mode, if you accidentally flip a switch, it won't do anything until you stop and restart, so you're fine there. But with this closed, you won't accidentally cut your gas engine while you're using it and potentially needing it. So that's it. Again, this mod would be intended for those who use their vehicle on their own private land. I envision a large country acreage with some need for putting around and a desire to not use any gas, even if it's a little cold out. Could you use this on the road? Perhaps. But like with all vehicle modifications, you must consult experts and not perform this work yourself. It's simply not advisable, and this video is not meant to accomplish such a task. What this video is meant to do is perhaps help you learn something about your vehicle or about cars in general. Remember to be responsible, safe, and of course, enjoy your drive wherever life takes you.